So here the aim comes to be verification of the sigma delta quantizer operation for a constant input signal. Now for sigma delta quantization operation and providing a constant input signal as the input here. So here we require the two important values for generation of the signal to feed it as input. So the one thing is, what is the length of the input sequence, and another thing, what is the amplitude level of the input sequence, and then we shall develop the sigma delta quantization operation. So the first task is to first of all generate the input signal. So now what we can do here, we can define few of the variables that hold the information regarding the input sequence length and that of the amplitude here. Now taking this particular MATLAB script to be user friendly here, we shall try to have a development as such. The input can be provided from the command window while we run this particular program at any time here. So we are trying to define the variable n so that can accept the value of how much length of the input signal can be set here. So to accept this particular value from the command window here, from the command prompt, we are going to make the use of input syntax here in the MATLAB here, and here a message shall be printed onto the command window here. The message here it is, enter the length of input sequence or input signal, whatever you call. So sequence is basically a signal here, but it is of the discrete type here. So I just close this particular MATLAB syntax with the help of a semicolon here. Now using this particular length, we require another variable that will be very much useful to us in further development here. So this varies with the value extending from 1 with the specific interval of 1 up to maximum value capital N here. So here 1:1 capital N, the capital N value that we are going to accept as the length of the input signal from the command window. And we also define one more variable that can be computed by using this particular small n as defined here. So input sequence we have accepted the length from the command window. Now we require to accept the amplitude value here. So for amplitude value, we define a variable by the name capital A here, and again making the use of input command within a pair of parentheses and a pair of single quotes here, we shall try to print a message here so that the user can input the value here. Enter the amplitude of input signal. So here we are accepting all necessary information for the input signal. Now it's time to have the input signal generated. We are already specified that we are going to provide the input signal to be having a constant amplitude level here. So let us say x is the variable that holds this particular input signal, and that we are going to define as we have two values, one into the variable capital A for the amplitude level and another into the variable capital N, that is the length here. So here we shall mathematically define it to be capital A multiplied by 1s, and within the parenthesis here we provide the input arguments 1 comma capital N here. So with the help of the MATLAB syntax 1s, every element is supposed to hold the amplitude level at 1 here, and when we multiply it with the capital A, that is what the amplitude the user is providing, so it will be getting shifted to that particular level, and every element is having the same. So we say here it is the constant amplitude signal we have been generating here. Now what signal we have generated, it should also be displayed onto the MATLAB window here. So for that purpose, we are going to make the use of plot command here. The input arguments will be small m comma small x here. M we have defined by using small n, which is in turn for the capital N. And now x just now we have formulated here. So now here it will be plot having the two axes here. There should be a nomenclature to the axis. So we have the horizontal axis and the vertical axis here. So the horizontal axis generally we refer to as x axis here. Nomenclature can be provided by the MATLAB syntax x label here. Now within the pair of parentheses and the pair of single quotes here, we shall have the information regarding the parameter plotted on this particular axis, that it is time here. In the similar fashion, we will like to have the nomenclature of the vertical axis, that it is the y axis here. So within a pair of parentheses and a pair of single quotes, we shall be writing it to be the amplitude level. Amplitude keyword is in up here. Now along with the nomenclature to both of the axes, the combined plot what we have by using this particular axis should also be provided a title here. So in the title syntax I just mentioned here, it is input analog signal. So ending this with the help of semicolon. Now with the help of the plot command, we expect whatever the input signal that we have generated is supposed to be displayed in a separate MATLAB window. In the same MATLAB window, after the sigma delta quantization operation will be performed, we will like to have the display changed to the quantized output here, so that whatever the effect of the sigma delta quantization is there on the input signal can be better studied here. So for getting the display into the same window, we are making the use of pause command here, and after this we will like to have generation of the output signal as a result of the sigma delta operation. For that purpose, we will like to have a definition of the variable named small y here, which is initially having all the elements to be zeros here, to start at 1, and we have capital N plus 1 as the second input argument here. Now for the generation of the exact quantized signal here, we shall take the help of one more variable that we define as V0. Initial value is 0 here, and now we are going to make the computations with the help of the for looping here. Now for for loop here, the index variable we define denoted by small k here, that starts at the value 2, extends at the interval of 1 in every iteration, and the maximum value here the k can hold is capital N plus 1. So up to 2 to capital N plus 1 the iterations we are going to make here. And here we shall not be ending this particular syntax with the help of semicolon here. Now inside the body of the for looping here, or at this particular point if I write end here, in between for keyword and end keyword, we shall be writing here v1 as the variable that it is computed by using the x, that is having k minus 1 within the parenthesis minus, here we have y in the parenthesis again k minus 1 here, and which is further added to v0. So now by the next step we shall have the computation of our intended signal y within parenthesis k we provide, and it can be SIGN function we are making the use of, and v1 as the input operand here, and finally v0 we update by v1, and further the for looping is extended here. So this is what the computation of the output signal we are trying here. Now the final computation we can make outside the for looping here. So after the end keyword here, we shall be writing the new form of the y. So I write yn here, and it is equal to y within the parenthesis, here we provide 2 up to capital N plus 1 here. And then we will like to have a plot of this output signal here. So for that purpose, we are going to make the use of axis within the parenthesis and a square bracket. Here we have the first element to be 0, then second one is N minus 1. Next to that we have minus 1.2, next to that 1.2 here, and we end the line with the help of semicolon. Now for the plotting purpose, as we have this in the discrete domain here, so we shall be writing stem here. So for continuous time domain representation, we make the use of plot command, whereas for discrete time domain representation, for display purpose, we make the use of stem command. The input arguments are small m, as computed earlier, comma y suffix n here, and this is to be ended with the help of semicolon. Again the nomenclature comes, so for horizontal axis we have y label and x label. First of all, so for x label, within the single quotes here I just mentioned time as we had earlier done. Then for y axis we have y label command, whereupon we mention within a pair of single quotes amplitude. Now after this nomenclature of axis, we want a title to this particular plot. So title here it is provided, it is output of, we have the use of sigma delta operation here. So sigma delta, either you write quantizer or modulator. Then finally on to the command prompt as well, whatever the average amplitude level we have obtained for the output signal, we will like to display here. So the average is supposed to be folded up by the variable that we define AVG here, and the average we compute by the use of sum function here. The input argument is YN, and this is divided by the total number of samples into the input sequence here. So for display purpose, onto the command prompt, here we are going to make the use of the command GISP here, and here the string can be printed. Here it is average value of output is the equal to sign and the space here, and by the next line we will like to print out the value here, and to the same command DISP we provide the input argument parameter here, that it is AVG here. We end this line with the help of semicolon here. Now we can save the script. You can see here into the current folder we are going to save it by the name program_8_19 here. .m will be the file extension. You can see the title of this particular editor window for the current case is changed to the new name that I have provided, and finally we have the same file that has been generated into the current folder as well here. Now as we have a plot for the input signal here, we also require the axis. So here we shall be mentioning after this particular syntax before labeling, that it is axis within the parenthesis and the square brackets, the arguments will be 0 and minus 1. Then we have minus 1.2 and plus 1.2 as we have done for representation of output signal as well. So now we save the changes made to it, and now it's time to run this particular program. So as we run this particular program, you can see the status at the left downwards here. Here it is waiting for the input, and onto the command window you can see a string that is enter the length of the input signal here. So for example, we will like to have the input signal of the length 20, and after hitting enter, it is again asking another information. It is asking enter the amplitude of the input signal. Let us say, for example, we provide the amplitude level at 0.9 here. Now we hit enter here. So here you can see the busy status of the MATLAB, and it is supposed to generate a MATLAB window here. So MATLAB window with the title figure 1 has been opened here, and you can see, as I maximize this window for better clarity, the horizontal axis is mentioning the parameter to be the time here, whereas onto the vertical axis we have amplitude plotted here. So for time, you can see the markings from 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18 there upon the amplitude level maximum. Beyond 1 we have, and you can see the plot here. So it is a constant amplitude throughout all these particular sequences here. And when you just mark anywhere onto this particular plots, you can see at different values of the x, y value is the same. Y value is 0.9, either you take for x is equal to 0, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 5, x is equal to 9, x is equal to 12, x is equal to 15, x is equal to 17, or you can also have x is equal to 7. Everywhere the amplitude level is the same here. So now I just restore it to the earlier view here. Now you can see the status here. The status is paused here. Press any key. Into the same window, that is with the name figure 1, we will like to have the output also displayed here. So I hit any of the key here. You can see again the busy status, and finally the changes appeared into the same MATLAB window. I just maximize it. You can see the first title that has been changed. Now the new title is output of sigma delta modulator, and again we have amplitude on the vertical axis and time as a parameter onto the horizontal axis, and the discrete samples you can see after the sigma delta quantization here. Now I get back to its earlier view here, and onto the command prompt you see the two values were accepted as input for the length and for the amplitude level. Afterwards, after executing this particular program, we have average value of the output also printed onto the command prompt. The value that it is printed is 0.9000 here. So this was what the program we had for sigma delta quantization when the case of input signal is of constant amplitude level here.